We're back, bitches. Stu's here because it's his show.
Hello.
I'm here because it's sort of my show, but not really. NXT's back.
Boo!
The Indiegogo was successful. What's the other one? The one named he uses anywhere? Is it GoFundMe?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. And what? Like, you had some big backers. I mean, Shane McMahon? I mean, here comes the money to NXT.
He donated £5 to get a mention in the credits.
As did Vince McMahon as well. He's a
$2
billionaire.
Backer, right?
Yeah.
He gets a key ring. Triple H?
It was Hunter Hearst Helmsley.
Hunter Hearst Helmsley, yes.
Yeah, same initials, but different man for some reason.
Bigger nose.
Former tag team champion. But yes, let's just... as usual, do you just want to not see the matches you've got?
Let's not spoil the incoming fun.
Alright, there is one thing we do need a... Oh, it's got rivals for this show. Oh. I'm not going to tell you what they are because they're brilliant.
Right.
But we do have one piece of business, and that is the Bread Championship.
Oh, yes.
Who is going to fight for it? I'm going to make this the first match because it's the least interesting one.
Oh, thanks a lot.
No, like from what the computer has booked, the first match is boring. The rest of them are brilliant.
Oh, so you mean like you're getting rid of what the first match is scheduled to make the Bread match?
Yes.
Right. Let's have...
And it could be any sort of match type.
Let's have... Last Man Standing. I can hear you dying already.
Oh my god. Yep. Last one standing.
And let's have it between Shane McMahon and Big E Langston.
Oh! Shane McMahon and Big E. And this will be for the Bread Championship.
The Bread Championship is fought under 24/7 rules because it is, of course, Bread the whole time.
Yes.
Etc.
So let me switch to the game now. And you'll get, maybe if you're quick eyed enough, you may get a quick glimpse of the rivalries, but there's like one of the rivalries is kind of like, yes. I want to see this. But yes, the Bread Championship. Shane McMahon, Big E, Langston. Why am I doing the play-by-play role? I'm the color commentator here.
No.
Fuck NXT.
No, you've got to be play-by-play. I've got to be color.
Oh, yeah, good point, because I'm the one with the live feed. You haven't to watch this.
I'm just watching it on the monitor.
But yeah, here comes the money. So was this the $5 the perk he got to be in the Bread Championship match?
People look, because he donated $5 and Big E needs $5. So we thought it'd work
there
well.
There you go then.
I like how he's Titantron, it's just other people. He's still got a Titantron or is it just a Tron these days?
I think it's still... They don't really call it anything, but yeah, it's a Titantron.
There's Shane McMahon coming out to pictures of Pat Patterson and Jerry Briscoe.
Who are in this game as managers. But you can't set managers in Universe.
Well, I suppose you could put them like as part of the stable or something.
Nope. They don't come up as... managers don't come up as an option.
That's weird.
Yep. Because otherwise, I would have so much managers. I would have made DiBiase manager for Goat Money.
Really? Because mm-hmm. surely he would be manager for the Virgil.
No.
Sorry, it's Vincent.
Yeah. I would have, I just thought the change in this match may have changed some of the other matches, but it doesn't matter anyway. There's the Bread Championship with the logo of Bread the whole time.
See, Big E's just waving around a blue towel, so I'm like, I can't remember if the else gets like a nice belt.
Oh, wait, I've got to do this right. There we go. I've started the match. Last man standing, folks. I can guarantee will not be me.
For those unaware, we did just record Raw.
Yes, it was a epic show. Main evented by Heath Slater, so that's all you need to know. Who will be in the main event for Raw's part of the next pay-per-view.
And before that, we recorded European Rampage 93.
92.
And WrestleMania Challenge 91.
Yep.
This has been a long session of wrestling. And we've only just begun.
I was about to say, we've only just started to lose our minds as Shane McMahon slaps Big E in the face.
Not a fan of the light up, what would you call it? Like ring apron, I guess.
Oh, the LED screen.
I don't think it works in NXT at all. I didn't like it at TakeOver, I don't like it. I just...
It was in NXT first.
Was it? Did they use it for like the special pay-per-views first?
I think they may have used it for the first TakeOver and then just kept it for all the other NXTs, but see, I like it when like the... Like partly like people's entrances, they'll have like an extra part of the arena movie, I guess. Yeah. It's quite distracting when it's flashing about.
Yeah. Especially with NXT being like really smaller and like just different.
Yeah.
The sort of like glamour and shitty all the lights. It's too smooth.
But like I say, it did start with NXT. And then they adopted it for Raw and SmackDown.
It's the kind of thing I would see like Ring of Honor doing, so they could try and like compete with WWE. Kind of like, oh, but we're no dark and dingy, look, we've got lights. But rather than above the ring, they're on the apron.
But yes, Big E driving Shane McMahon's shoulder into the post. Big E obviously wants to hold the Bread Championship.
Something about the booty.
Oh, Big Man getting out a Singapore cane and try to crack over the head of Big E, but Big E grabs the cane and hits it across McMahon's ribs.
Biggie and Sasha. Like the greatest Twitter accounts out there.
Yeah.
Like, I know this is the Bread match and I should be plugging Bread, but go follow Biggie and Sasha Banks. Oh, holy shit.
They should be doing that anyway. Like, New Day and Team Bad backstage. Like, just all the videos they've been putting up are fantastic.
Did you see their Mario Kart one?
Yes!
Oh, that was amazing. go follow Bread CWT on Twitter. Links to the Bread videos. Understand why this championship's got a loaf of bread photoshopped into that bit. Oh fuck! But I like Big E's. Oh, see,
like Big E's always had a great Twitter.
Like since the start. They've only just let him do the comedic stuff with renew day, I guess. But even then, yeah. Not as much as they, like, the fucking backstage stuff, the stuff on Vine, and what, pardon me, and whatnot should be on Raw. That'd be far more entertaining than half the stuff.
Oh, but apparently, like, when they started off their, like, gospel thing, when they, like, figured out this wasn't working, they just, like, went backstage, like, look, let us just be ourselves. If it doesn't work out, fire us. And then they're like, okay. And it honestly worked out. Oh, Biggie's been down for a count of 8, but he gets up in time.
Did you see back when the, like, the best team in the world were the killer? Was Ziggler, Biggie, and AJ. Like, they were doing conventions and fan access, and, like, somebody brought Biggie a pony.
Yes!
And, oh, even that was fucking, it was amazing.
Mm.
I do have, like, really high hopes for the guy.
Like, ever since I first, like, even when I first saw him, just as Dolph Ziggler's enforcer, I was like, this guy's got, he's got it.
You hadn't seen him in NXT? Like,
I've seen him a little bit, but, like, not enough to be like,
he would fucking squash people and, like, hold them down for the 5 count and,
yeah.
Like, then fucking, like, give them another slam and then hold them down for another 5 count. Like, he was a beast. Kid, they booked him like he was fucking Goldberg.
Wait, McMahon going for the coast to coast.
They really, really, like, built him up to be something. But of course, he's only, yeah, like, 6'2" or something.
Yeah, but when you look like what he does, I mean,
aye, but it would be hard to offer the, like, he's a beast sort of gimmick when he's fighting Mark Henry or Kane or Big Show.
They did it with Rhino. Again, okay, maybe not a best example, but oh, I think Shane McMahon just won the match.
Oh.
Yep, Shane McMahon is the new and first.
Was that you ringing the bell?
Red champion. Yes. What a win on Shane O'Mac's number one match.
Shane McMahon's favourite type of bread is, of course, the baguette. Other types of bread are available. For more information on your favourite wrestler's favourite type of bread, you're going to have to do a bit of Googling.
Or you can just watch NXT every Wednesday night.
Like if Biggie wins next week, I'll tell you, like, he likes rolls.
You've just spoiled it.
Titus scones, I've got some bread in them.
Yeah. The next match is Lord Steven Regal versus Simon Gotch. Which would actually be a fantastic match. I have high hopes for this match, if you can't tell.
I have Sparky Plug's Wikipedia page open.
Okay. What is that telling you about Sparky Plug?
Dave Meltzer, editor of The Wrestling Observer, wrote in a lot of books, you think you're reading what the person writing feels is the right thing to say for their career. With Holly, whether you agree or not, and I agree with some stuff but not others, I had no doubt he was giving his true opinions on things. In that sense, it was a very honest look at a period in WWF history from a guy who's had ups and downs but survived a long time. However, he did train Mark Morgan.
Oh. Oh, tough enough. He didn't really train him. He was just on tough enough.
He trained him in OVW.
I know it's like all the Tough Enough alumni have like trained by whoever was the coaches that season.
You remember when Triple H was on? I can't remember who the main coaches were. Triple H was there, and he's like, "Take a bump," or "Slap me," something like that.
Yeah.
So we got him, and he's like, "If you were gonna do that out there, I would beat the utter fuck out you. Do it properly." And he just went fucking nuts on them.
I don't know if you've been watching Breaking Ground.
No, because I cancelled my network subscription.
But there's a very interesting part where they've got the tryouts, and the rookies do that. The people trying out keep doing that thing where they're rolling forward and then they hop when they go up, and William Regal just went fucking apeshit. Because at first he was just like, when you do that, just put left foot forward, you don't need to hop. And then they kept doing it, everybody. And eventually he just went, like, honestly, just started screaming. Being like, am I the one who's fucking... Like, he didn't swear, but it's like, am I the one who's incredibly thick here as all of you? Left foot forward! And they honestly were on a big, like, tirade. And the rest of them just, like, the guy in the ring just could not speak. Because, like, Regal was just going crazy. Understandably so, to be honest. And then there was, like, Albert just sitting back being like, yeah, if I ever listen to the man.
And if they're not going to listen to Rico, they're fucked.
Yeah. Because, Albert's the head coach, but Regal, when he speaks, you fucking listen.
Look, I mean, I get, like, Albert's been in Japan and things like that, and he obviously knows what he's doing, but Regal has got fucking... He's got 40 years on him.
I think... I'm just judging this by the fact that both the head trainers have been good but fairly unspectacular, like, wrestlers. I don't think they want, like, people with, like, a specific brand of style, if you know what I mean. They want people who are fairly generic to train people, so
that's what
they can build up.
Like, they send people to NXT to fucking train the uniqueness out of them.
Yeah. But,
remember, like, everybody was like, oh, El Generico fucking kicks ass. And then Sami Zayn came out and he had, like, the hipster fucking, like, old man hat on. And, like, a pinstripe blazer and a pair of tight jeans. Like, what the fuck happened there?
I like Sami Zayn.
They let Owens be Steen. You know what I mean?
To be fair, I don't think a character like Generico, like, that's a very indie character, but yeah, it was a bit strange just seeing him without a mask. But you know, now that I've gotten used to it, it doesn't bother me at all.
But they've new, like, the only mask wrestler they had was Rey Mysterio.
And they've got Kalisto. They've got Sin Cara. They've got the Demon Kane. But not Corporate Kane, he's
on. Are they still doing the Abyss storyline with Kane?
No. After he lost to Seth, they've sort of... He ended up getting kidnapped by the Wyatt family, and then him and Undertaker made their return on Raw. And I think on Survivor Series, it's going to be Brothers of Destruction versus two members of the Wyatt family, because a Survivor Series match would make too much sense. But no, he's back to just being full-on Kane again.
Except for in the game where he's just Corporate Kane and no normal Kane.
Yeah, there is a masked Kane in the game. But, Oh, Gotch, being very cocky, doing push-ups on Regal's back. Of course, Lord Steven Regal, no relation to Raw Superstar Bulldog Regal.
No, they're not related. They're no relatives.
Oh, Regal going for the pin.
I don't think...
One, two, three, and no kick out. Just in the last second.
Regal's tights were always made of a sort of weird red wine. Like, and they looked like they were made of like velvet.
Yeah. Well, that is one thing. You can change the material of clothes in this game.
That's nice.
But, like, your options are like cloth, vinyl, metallic.
Vinyl. Those are everybody looking like the Funkos.
There's a few others, but I can't remember. It's like, oh, Regal's calling for something, though. Will it be... It's that... Oh, what does Regal call this, suplex?
What a maneuver.
That's it, what a maneuver! But, Gotch's foot was on the ropes. Gotch, of course, his power comes from his mustache.
Really?
No, I just made that up right now. I'm trying to make his character a bit more interesting.
I thought it was for like the wee belt thing, anyways.
It could be both.
Because that's holds all the power in his upper body and stops it escaping through the feet.
There we go. See, of course, Martin would know more about his NXT superstars than me. Oh, Gotch with the pin. One.
I used to wrestle
two.
In the old timey days.
So, in that case, if you were up against Simon Gotch, how would you counter him?
I'd step to the left.
Fair enough. Hello, Gok. 666, how are you today? Oh, Regal going up top. He's got the underhook suplex on. And down goes Gotch. Surely that must be it for the throwback superstar. Regal decided to drag him from the... Oh, dirty pin. The referee can clearly see it, but he's clearly ignoring it. And Gotch loses his debut because Steven Regal's a dirty little cheater.
Steven Regal, of course, knows how to counter Gotch.
Oh, and now Steven Regal's offering his hand, but Gotch says no. I think we're about to get... ourselves a little rivalry going on here.
Come on, Regal. It's just a jump to the left. And then a step to the right. Put your hands on your hips. Bring your knees in tight. Oh, you heard,
Simon Gotch's...
you heard Christopher Lee read this?
No.
Oh, I'll need to link that to you.
Yeah. But yes, Gotch's frustrations are growing after his loss to Regal. That's what the game just told me.
Two
life.
Two things I would highly recommend you check out is Christopher Lee reading the Time Warp lyrics,
yes.
And also Christopher Lee doing the audiobook for The Exorcist.
But yes, sorry, the next match was originally AJ versus Emma. It has changed.
Oh.
It's now AJ versus Layla making her debut. And Gok is great. He's glad to see something different from Fallout. Oh, Emma!
That's the Eric Clapton.
Emma just attacked Layla and now is coming into the ring. This match is just...
Did
Layla
interrupt AJ Lee's intro?
No, she interrupted Layla's. AJ got the jobber entrance.
AJ got the jobber entrance? Oh my god.
I can't believe Emma would be so heinous.
I can't but look at the fucking, what have they done to Emma?
But yes, AJ, the current NXT Women's Champion. Emma wants her belt back. But first she's going to have to learn how to, you know, win.
Well, she... It helps if Charlotte remembers to pin the right person. Shout out to NXT for 2 months ago. It's not a horrible AJ. They've got the outfit and things right.
Yeah. The face is kind of a picture of her face.
Aye, but you can do that now. You just like taking a picture and wrap it around.
Yeah. It's not as horrible as my attempt to create a Reggie from Nintendo.
I bet you there's a good Reggie existing though.
Yeah, probably. I downloaded a picture, but it had a background which fucks up their face recognition. So he ends up with two eyes, two lips.
Well, you generally need two eyes, two lips, and one nose.
Sorry, two pairs.
Alright. It's like he ends up like a normal person.
I don't even know if this is an official match, but they've just been fighting on the outside for a while. Oh, Fisherman's Carry by Emma. Oh, AJ, countering the scoop slam. Pushing Emma away. Crucifix pin. Oh, wait, not. Just a crucifix, I guess.
Have they changed it up so you can look, go into the crowd or anything this year?
You cannot go into the crowd. And there's no backstage arenas either. That hasn't been for a while now.
I suppose, like, when was the last... Like, what fucking...
AJ goes for the pin. I guess this is now an official match.
Raven
I guess you
versus Kane versus Big Show.
There's been, like, a few matches that have, like, gone to the backstage. Last one being Ambrose versus Harper.
Mm.
So I guess you just decided to make this an official match then, Martin.
Well, Emma should be champion.
No bias here, folks. But AJ's calling for something.
He's just calling Phil. Like, do you know Emma just took out the person who I was supposed to be having a match with? And now she's here like, oh, like, fucking, I'm going to beat you when it's not even a match. If that was
AJ
like,
goes for the pin.
This is why I don't work there anymore.
Oh! Came so close to AJ pinning Emma there.
So it's like rid of AJ's music.
Yeah.
You'd think they'd keep stuff like that in because they own it anyway.
You'd think, but it's just like. What, this is sort of get rid of everything. Once like someone leaves. They sort of get rid of everything to do with them, apart from their entrances.
And sometimes they leave the signs then.
Yeah. But like, you can still have like, people coming out to Corey Graves' like entrance moves. Oh, what a move by Emma. She's all kept up and hit AJ with the Hurricanrana. Very smooth.
What a maneuver.
Oh, backbreaker. Or backstabber, even, by Emma. That's a backbreaker. And that's oh, it's a submission move as well. Will AJ tap? No.
It is sort of interesting that the games are no.
The games are no.
They've no took that massive leap that everybody expected. Like, oh, when 2K buys Ur, it's gonna be like the fucking basketball games with like constant updates and like stat adjustments and all the things that the other 2K games have.
They do have the 2K style of My Career now. It's a lot better than 2K15's. Oh, belly to belly by AJ. Shades of someone who should have been in the fucking game. And AJ goes for the pin. One, two, three. And AJ wins. Emma's seventh straight loss, and that is why she is the number one contender.
I have four divas this year.
No, you have five. You forgot Fox.
Oh, I have Alicia Fox as well.
Yep.
See, that's pretty good. I have like an actual division this time instead of just three people. It would have been nice to have Bailey.
It would have been nice to have Sasha. Bailey, Sasha, Becky, and Charlotte.
See, like, it's horrible, but I don't think they're going to do much with Becky. Unfortunately.
Probably. You know. She does seem to be the one who's there, but she's talented enough that she'll.
She's good, but. Don't know. Maybe when fucking thingy makes the jump to the main roster.
Bailey.
No, Devitt.
Oh yeah. Finn Balor.
Aye. Maybe when he makes the jump to the main roster.
Maybe. They are like best buds in real life as well. Because they would have known each other from Ireland again. Like,
well, he trained
Ireland
them.
Wrestling scene. Really? Oh. For some reason, I thought she'd been wrestling a lot longer than that.
Well, she was wrestling for a while and then she stopped. She got really, like, hurt or something.
Yeah.
But he trained her. Like, in Ireland.
Oh, speaking of Finn Balor, he's in his next match. It is an elimination tag match.
Does he only come out as the demon for pay-per-views? Or is it a demon out of your entrance?
I don't know. I know there's both. Yeah, he's normal here. But I'm sure he would come out as the demon on pay-per-views. But probably not when he's part of the Bulldog Club. Don't know. Won't know until the end of the month. But yes, it's the Bulldog Club versus the halftime players.
I like my names. I don't like that it's the same makeup. And I get that all, like, for branding purposes and all that kind of shit.
Yeah.
But it just gets boring when it's the same all the time.
Yeah, last time, like, it was the New York one, he had a much more extensive body paint as well. Like, his entire, like, chest and back were painted. But that might have just been because it was Brooklyn.
Oh, but it's still generally the same design.
Yeah.
Wag and everyone.
But like, I think it's okay since it's just the special events he does it in. Oh, but he didn't even do it for the last takeover. Like, it's literally only like the big matches.
Where was the last takeover though?
It was back in the NXT arena, but he was part of the Dusty Rose Classic teaming with Samoa Joe. Yeah.
Oh my god, the halftime players are doing the entrance.
Yeah, I made sure. I did change all the entrances to try and.
Also, like Santino's sort of heel attire.
Oh yeah, I didn't even notice that. This is the first time I've seen Santino in this game. They actually changed his attire for some reason. Yes, this is the STUniverse debut of both Bulldog and Balor.
And both tag teams as well.
Yes. Titus O'Neil had one match in the STUniverse before, in season one. That was like, I actually remember this. It was against Darren Young on the first show.
I think I fell asleep.
Yeah, I think we all did. Santino Marella.
I think you're confusing it with Raw.
No, I remember every minute of every Raw because it just grips me.
What happened with that? If any of you saw Raw this week, you would have seen the elimination match.
Yeah, that was a great match. Who would have thought Heath Slater pinning the Ultimate Warrior and becoming the number one contender for Warriors Championship at the next pay-per-view?
Sadly, Bulldog here has already stolen Ultimate Warrior's boots. And arm tassels.
Well, he is bizarre. And someone is setting off fireworks outside. Hopefully that is not Audible.
No, Audible is the audiobook service from Amazon.
Oh,
and they are not plugging us. Also not plugging us, I've noticed, is Redbox. They took that out this year.
Ah, what a shame. Titino's is still in it, though.
Like, do they have, like, if you do a pay-per-view, does it come up, like, sponsored by Snickers?
No, but we can.
Or, like, Skittles, or M&M's, or...
Though, nowadays, this is time to plug the most recent WWE movie. Which is currently The Condemned 2, starring Randy Orton and Eric Roberts.
I like how you said that, like, you were the part of the commentary team there.
I am part of the commentary
Orton
team.
And Eric Roberts.
And then after that is Santa's Little Helper, starring The Miz and Paige.
Really?
Why do I know WWE Studios release schedule? But yeah, they both had to take time out to film it.
Fuck's sake.
Considering being a movie star is The Miz's gimmick, it's fitting.
I put Paige?
Mm-hmm.
I actually remember her on Total Divas. She was filming some scenes for a film. That might have been what it was.
Yep. Bulldog pinning Titus. Could it be it? Oh, only a one count. So Santino Marella, former tag champion on SmackDown.
They got enough people on the roster where they could do a sort of like British gangster film.
A British gangster film.
Where like Regal's like a fucking again like the heat like Ken.
Well, they've got Regal, Barrett,
Neville.
Neville, yeah, I knew it was someone else. Who else have we got that's actually British or not?
I guess Layla's not there anymore.
No, she's not. Though, I know she's Scottish, but Kaylee Ray debuted on NXT last week. She's a very good local wrestler. I don't know if she's signed by WWE, but she made a... She wrestled Nia Jax. No, I was about to say, like, Nia Jax, they took all of 2 weeks to point out that she was The Rock's cousin.
Oh, fuck's sake.
Because, you know, she was, like, she can't just be a badass woman. No, she has to be a badass woman who's The Rock's cousin. So she could be really good. But yeah, what were you going to say?
Blue Pants been fired?
She's never been properly hired.
Are they still using her, or is she, like, done?
They haven't used her since TakeOver. Right. But then she was never contracted. That's why, like, apparently a lot of people in NXT were kind of pissed off at how much of a reaction she was getting.
Well, but it's their fault. Like, if she can go over just, like, based on fucking nothing, then...
No, fun fact, her name and theme song, her name was made by Enzo Amore, and her theme song is sung by Colin Cassidy.
But then, like, there's no excuse for, like, Bill Fett or whoever. His name's not Bill Fett, is it? But he's
no, that's his gimmick, yeah. His gimmick's
Bill Fett.
Shake, I don't hate Bill Dempsey. I think he's fine. Like, he's an okay wrestler.
Who's the one who... What, did they know of, like, some sort of controversy? Because it was, like, Last Kicker t-shirts.
That was Becky.
Did they not get banned?
I don't think so. I know the original name for Paige, Becky, and Charlotte's group got had to get changed after a week.
Submission.
No, it was a submission to sorority. Yeah, which is a name of a certain kind of website.
A what website?
A certain kind of website.
Which kind of website?
I'm pretty sure it's
a sort of private member has paid to enter a website.
Yes.
Very much so.
Which apparently Paige pointed out to them.
A lot of people on there dressed as like members of Demolition.
Wrestling, everybody.
You know, was it Lacey Von Erich and a bunch of like people where they were in TNA? Like they did all the stuff to make money. And like it wasn't porn, but they did these apparently like some weird sort of first person view, like wrestling things.
Yes. I'm pretty sure Sonny was involved in one of them as well.
And TNA like really weren't happy about it.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure like Lacey, Sonny, maybe Missy Hyatt as well, maybe.
Oh no, this was like it was Lacey, and I remember it wasn't Mark Morgan, but it was like some of the male talent.
Oh, alright. I don't. Oh, wait, no. Sonny is the one you can pay to talk to via webcam with.
I heard like she was selling Skype shows.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm in a sort of wrestling group on Facebook. I'm never on Facebook, but one time I was on and like she was in like trolling people.
Sorry, Santino just hit Finn with the Cobra. This could Finn could be eliminated right here. It's a one. It's a two. Finn Balor has been eliminated by Santino Marella. It's now just Bulldog versus halftime players.
Somebody was like taking the piss because she's got that and she's got like legal problems and all the rest. And she came in and started fucking like shouting and roaring. It's a really big group and they keep having like fucking like Ian Rotten showed up and he's a piece of shit. Like they keep having weird stuff like that. The things you become a part of after writing some shitty wee columns for a wrestling website.
Oh, Bulldog has Santino on the top rope. Let's go for a superplex, yes. Now Bulldog picking Santino up. Can Bulldog do it all by himself?
Nah.
And Santino picks out too. Well, I'm glad Bulldog has the support of his general manager.
Bulldog is, I remember he died, right?
Yeah.
And then, but 2 or 3 months later, he was back in WWF. Honestly, like after reading it in the paper, and he was on WWF, and he was wrestling for quite a run, and then somebody threw a bin at him at Rebellion or something like that, and he was all fucked up, and then he died again for real.
No, because he came back. Was immediately put. I think he came out for a UK pay per view. Was immediately put in the main event and then started hanging out with the Mean Street Posse. I never watched it at this point. This is what I know after the fact. Oh, Marella goes to pin Bulldog. It's one. It's two. And Bulldog kicks out.
Him and Anvil, for what I've read, were no nice people.
I'm not surprised. But you know, who are nice people? That's not grammatically correct at all.
Nah, Beatdown sounds a piece of shit.
Well, the halftime players are treating Bulldog like he's a piece of shit. This is just a dissection, and now Titus with a knee to the head of the artist formerly known as Davey Boy Smith.
Oh, that's right. So, like, he went to WCW.
Yes. He was one of the Shockmaster's partners.
No, I don't mean then.
Oh. Did he know? Yeah, he went to WCW after the screw job. No, it was after the screw job. He came back. Yeah. Because him and Anvil left WWE after the screw job to join Brett in WCW, and then they did nothing.
So it was in WCW at the time where like the papers had printed that he died, and he hadn't died. Mm.
One. So I think Titus may have won here. Oh, 2.9.
Bye, that was a weird one.
Yeah. Well, he's still alive in this match.
I mean, Yokozuna was there for a UK tour.
Mm-hmm.
And he was wrestling like fucking 4 miles away, and I wanted to go, but I didn't. And like a month later, he was dead, I know.
Mm.
Have you ever been to a WWF?
I actually have not. I'm still thinking about if I'm going to go to NXT or not. They're in Glasgow next month. Aye. And Marella is staring intently at Bulldog's back. Oh, he finally does something. But I've been to local shows.
The local Aberdeenian at the ballroom?
Yeah. No, I've not been to the ballroom, but I did train with WrestleZone for a while.
Right.
So I went to their shows quite a lot and helped out, like, set up the ring. For one show in, like, West Hill, I was there, one of the merch guys.
Well, they only do their big ones at the ballroom, do they?
Yeah, though they've got Foley coming in, and that show's at the Beach Leisure Center. They've got Foley coming in, I think, next week, but the tickets have sold out. But hey, because they sell out the ballroom, like, print. Like, I'm very pleased to see how successful they got.
It's not my type of product.
Mm. It's purposely very family friendly. Bulldog crawling for a lazy pin attempt on Marella. But, oh, Marella kicks out. But they do have some good rosters there.
Oh, but they get, like all the sort of... Well, like, I guess, the, like, all the British talent, like, daily rounds, basically.
Hmm. Well, they have their own... Because they train their own people. Aye. They have a lot of their own talent. But Grado's a regular.
Aye.
Jack Jester.
Whiplash.
Whiplash, no. Uh-huh. Never wrestled. Uh-huh. WrestleZone, nope. Noam Dar used to.
Aye.
He hasn't for a while.
Like Whiplash went in from there. That's what it was.
Oh, another Cobra by Marella on Bulldog. This might be over.
I guess that
goes for the pin.
The gimmick doesn't lend itself to.
And there it is. The halftime players dominating the Bulldog Club.
To a good show.
Galloway wrestled last year's Leisure Show match. Event, even.
Aye, Galloway's.
But that's the only one he's done. Because he's, like, he spends his time either in ICW or TNA.
Aye, but is he really spending time at TNA?
I think no one's spending time in TNA. They taped all their shite months ago. That's why they had Matt Hardy win the title, then had to make up this bullshit thing about him dropping it, because they had already filmed 3 months worth of Impacts.
Aye, but you know at the end of that, Matt Hardy wins at the end of the 3 month.
Are you kidding me? Oh, I hate fucking TNA. Like, the sooner, honestly, like, the sooner they die, the better. Like, yeah, people will be out of jobs, but Jeff Jarrett will give them all jobs. But yeah, bad debut for the Bulldog Club. They gotta know that they're in the big leagues now. No, wait, sorry, I thought I was still commentating Raw.
Like, I wish ICW would come up.
Yeah, well, they do shows. They have, part of their Fear and Loathing tour. They have a show in Edinburgh called Fear and Loathing.
Loathing, aye.
And I need to go to the next one.
And it's no even, like, it's no, like, the blood, like, and all that kind of shit.
They're generally entertaining. Aye. Promotion.
It's like they're entertaining, they're fun.
I mean, there's a reason why BBC made not one but two documentaries about them in the past year. They got a brilliant cast of characters and they just put on good shows. And now, oh my god, I think this might be the main event. It is Cactus Jack, the hardcore champion, decided by random because you need a new hardcore champion, versus the Iron Sheik.
Fucking bullshit.
Who quite clearly has Simon Koch's moustache. Oh, Bo Dallas though is interfering. He's going to be at Sheik's corner.
Oh, they should have stretched that moustache. Shoot, that's weird. Wait, do I still have Sheik and...
No. Because I don't want doppelgangers are too similar. Besides, Mustafa was not great. Like, stats wise around them.
But Neela Sheik, he's not even got the fucking pointy boots here.
Actually, that is a bit odd, considering the pointy boots should be in the game. Because they were in the last one. I will see if I can change that. Oh, she already go for pinfall, but Jack kicks out. So yeah, because like your former hardcore champion was one of the Canes, but Kane ended up on SmackDown. So just by random, I gave you a new hardcore champion, and that was Cactus Jack. And I think Bo Dallas wants the hardcore championship.
Maybe he just wants to watch Iron Sheik wrestle.
Maybe. Sheik already going for a pin. It's one. It's two. Oh, Cactus Jack kicks out.
It's because you're playing on PlayStation, isn't it? I was going to say, there's a lot more people in the crowd this time.
Yeah, they didn't release the PC version this year.
You think they will, like, 6 months in the road again?
They said that they were not talking about it, which... I don't think the PC version did too well, like, honestly. Like, a lot of people didn't like it because it was glitchy on the first day. And I don't think it sold particularly great. Mainly because everybody who wanted it already had it by that point. I think if they released it at the same time...
That's a big problem on PC, as these companies will be like, oh, because of piracy, we're releasing it on PC like 3-4 months later. It's like, alright, so everybody who wants the game's bought it on fucking console. And so then you greet that you're no selling any on PC when... Like... You fucked yourself out of a sale, basically.
But if it was, if I did it on the PC, I would not have got my Stone Cold Steve Austin pop vinyl figure.
You might have done. You can still buy the game case with a Steam code inside it.
Oh, wait, there's a cutscene happening. I mean, there's something happening in the match that's totally happening in real life. Bo Dallas is distracting Cactus Jack. And Iron Sheik attacks from behind.
I was right, he is with a Sheik then.
Yeah, like, he came out and Sheik was clapping when he first came out, so.
Ah, but that's just like, well done, Bo, you managed to walk.
Sometimes it's very hard for Bo to even get out of bed in the morning. But then he begins to believe.
He bogans.
He bogans, yes. And my TV is about to turn itself off.
Oh, mine's just that as well. Usually during...
Yeah, even my TV knows how shit NXT is. Cactus Jack just did a big move, I think. And now he goes for a pin. Oh, and she kicks out.
Sing Cactus Jack's theme.
Na 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 na.
Do you think we'll get a fucking a copyright strike because of that?
Banned. That is Cactus Jack's new nickname. Banned worldwide. Cactus Jack. Oh, kick out.
I did a Britney Spears like remix thing. And it got my YouTube account banned in Germany. it was like in the style of 80s pop and whatnot. But I recorded like a, just a quiet acoustic cover of a Chris Isaac song.
And that is the police coming to arrest you for doing
it's
that.
It's Cesaro's theme. and Chris Isaac's no like fucking kind of huge.
Sheik just beat Cactus Jack.
Oh shit! And he's no known for being like litigious. Or litigious, like he's not known for suing people.
Yeah.
So that was a fucking weird one. So I wrote a wee email to Chris Isaac, being like, "Come on, man, what are you doing to me?" He never replied.
Oh.
But you could probably get a cactus thing in as fair use.
What I've done is just. The entire thing is available on Twitch. I'm just going to make a quick video, maybe at the start of the bonus episode that we did before Raw. Just being like, if you want to watch the draft, just go on Twitch. Because even without that, I was still had about 20 copyrights because of all the other music and videos. I think one of the episodes must have been NXT got banned in Germany because of that guy, oh, what's his name, Terry Balboa, and his theme music was...
Oh, Terry Balboa's theme music. I can't do it, Rocco. You're gonna have to fight for me, huh?
Oh, that was not the main event. I lied. But of course. Of course. Oh, Cactus Jack's match went awry due to the distraction from rival Bo Dallas. That's going to be one of your pay-per-view matches. Bo Dallas versus Cactus Jack.
And what did you say, Terry Rocco?
Terry Balboa.
And so Terry Balboa's trainer is Mikey. Who's Mikey's brother.
Oh, for fuck's sake. The main event, ladies and gentlemen, is a Falls Count Anywhere between NXT champion Neville and Martin's favourite superstar, Randy Orton.
I suggest you just go and make a cup of tea during Orton's entrance.
Well, Neville's coming out first with his cape. Will he be able to take it off properly? Yeah! He's already achieved a victory today. Of course, Neville beat Iron Sheik and Doppelganger Ultimate Water to win the NXT title.
Aye, that's a load of pish. I told you he won that for Iron Sheik. Sheik was supposed to be champ one.
Instead, he's not even champ two.
God, they're really, like, invested in Neville's cape this year. And look, they gave him purple dye as well. You mean last year he had the horrible grey?
Yes. But now that he's on the main roster, they can afford to put a bit more time into him, I guess. Here comes Randy Orton.
Who's got Stardust?
SmackDown.
Fuck, SmackDown's got everybody.
SmackDown's getting a lot of DLC as well. Let's see what SmackDown got in the draft. Like, notable people at least. I'm upset because they're getting Boss Man. Dude Love. Dusty, when he's released. Farouk, Hideo Tami, Jake the Snake, Kama Mustafa.
What, Kama Mustafa's DLC?
No, he's in the game as part of the nation. Rikishi, Samoa Joe and Scott Hall, who are both DLC. Sin Cara, Trish, which is released. Typhoon, when he's released. And Vader next back.
Oh, so we'll not get to relive the glory of Typhoon versus the Bulldog.
No.
No, wasn't it? Was it? Ah, it was. No, it was Typhoon versus
Randy Savage. Who you still have as well.
Wrestler.
Actually, I just looked. Earthquake is going to SmackDown as well. Oh.
SmackDown's got beef the natural disasters.
Yes.
But
they're not going to be the natural disasters.
I don't know, it sounds like a good roster.
Mm-hmm. It will be once the DLC's released.
There's no Enzo, there's no Fernando.
Hey, Enzo will be a star once he begins winning matches. But you're right, SmackDown does not have, you know, Neville, Randy Orton, the one Billy Gunn, Cactus Jack, Iron Sheik, Virgil.
No one Billy Gunn, right? Orton, like I got rid of Orton and I still ended up with him.
Yeah, you got rid of Rookie Orton and then your Orton beat mine in the Doppelganger show that I've never posted because it was like I tried to commentate on it, mm-hmm. and it's just too confusing, so I was just like, you know, I'll just say the results on the draft show instead. I'm still like, I'm really pissed off that your Undertaker beat my one, because I had the actual Undertaker, you had the 91 Undertaker, and then your one popped up in the draft and I was like, yes, I may get him back. No, you kept him anyway. Powerbomb by Neville.
Like I said last year, like I would rather my roster was just the actual NXT peoples, you know what I mean?
And you've got a fair amount of them. And then you just fired one as well. You've got a lot of people who either were or are in NXT. Baron Corbin, Big E, Bo, Dean Ambrose, Emma, Eric Rowan.
But I don't have Kenta. No. Page.
No.
What's the situation with a shield? Do I still have Ambrose?
Yes. Right. But the rest are on SmackDown.
SmackDown really does have everybody.
So I think SmackDown lacks the big, like, classic names, but it has a lot of, like, current day.
You're lacking, like, classic goons. Names. It's got Jake the Snake. It's, like, Boss Man. Scott Hall. The Natural Disasters.
I mean, they don't have most of those yet. Oh, Neville pinning Orton on the outside, but Orton kicks out. So that's the thing. In 4 weeks' time, you're going to have to decide who's going to be the number one contender for Neville's championship. It could be Randy Orton.
No, I think it's Iron Sheik, because Neville promised Sheik the championship.
So is this official? Are you booking Neville versus Sheik at Hell in a Cell? I don't even think it's at Hell in a Cell. I think it's...
Is it Rage in the Cage?
No, I think it's Battleground. We've not even done SummerSlam yet. Alright, so due to Neville being a man of sort of his word, Neville will take on Iron Sheik for the NXT Championship in 4 weeks' time. I have wrote it in my book, therefore it is so. But then again, I've also wrote Ultimate Warrior versus Heath Slater. I'm going to find some way to change that match.
No, you can't. It's done. It's happened. It's fine, because, like, Slater was doing that, like, the gimmick where, like, the classic wrestlers would beat the shit out of him.
Yes. Including SmackDown Superstar Vader.
See, you're like, oh, SmackDown's not getting the classic. Like, you don't get much bigger than fucking Vader.
Oh yeah, and they also got The Rock off for me.
So SmackDown's got everybody. Is that what you're saying?
Yes.
Apart from, like, maybe Randy Savage.
Yeah, think about it, yeah. Like, we came out of the draft being like, fucking Martin's won the draft, but SmackDown, I think, quite... Oh, there's a table. Yeah, but I think SmackDown is quietly winning the universe. But then again, any show that doesn't have fucking Virgil is winning the universe. And Neville is consistently walking into the corner with the table. And now he's swinging the table around like he's dancing.
Virgil equals ratings, Stu.
Look, 0.01 may be a rating to some people.
We got a buy rate of 0.1.
That was from Virgil. Oh, Neville pinning Orton. Oh, it's a two count. Oh, Neville going up top. Will it be looking for the red arrow?
Oh, shit.
No. Instead, oh! Orton countered it into an RKO. This might be it. Orton goes for the pin. The referee's hands falling for it. Oh, Neville kicks out and Orton cannot believe it.
You scrolling through the fucking Twitter again?
No? Oh, is my pen lid making noise? Oh, so I'll put that down.
I used to play...
Power Slam by
Orton. I used
Orton.
To play with, like, bits of metal and things during, like when we record stuff. Or, like, during streams or whatever. But now I play with Blue Tack because it's quiet.
So that's the thing, I just, like, because I'm not writing in my trusty booking book. Oh, Orton goes for the pin. It's a two. Ah, he kicks out. So I'm always, like, playing with my pen, but then... If it wasn't the pen, I'd be playing with something else. Like this battery.
But can you not hold back? Is this match just too sexual for you?
No. I stay. Oh, I think Orton just punted Neville. But no, I saved that for a Raw. Because I like it Raw.
There was an old dirty bastard by way of the Ultimate Warrior.
So that was actually one of their slogans in the early days. They'd have like ring girls hold up signs saying I like it Raw. But then for some reason, they would always have like one like 50-year-old slightly overweight woman come in as well. And I'm sure Vince thought that was funny, but...
What? So wait, what came first, the ODB song? Oh.
Well, Raw started in 93.
Aye, but like they signs, did they start in 93?
Yeah, they started at the beginning.
And when did Return to the 36 Chambers come out? 95.
So there you have it. ODB is a fan of Monday Night Raw. And Neville goes to pin Orton. Will it be enough? Oh,
I don't know if they're still on my YouTube, but I did make a few wrestling videos like chatting about things, and I'll try to promote a site that was launching a long time ago, like, and like for back...
Neville just hit Orton with the RKO!
For backing music, like I remade some Wu-Tang Clan songs. And Shimmy Shimmy Ya, like it uses one note for a fucking, I can't remember if it's Stevie Wonder or Elton John. It uses one piano note for the start of this fucking song. And just loops it and alters the pitch and shit. I've got a lot of love for Louis.
Orton! Orton just lost to Neville.
Really?
Yes, Neville, the champion, looking strong, going into his title defense against Iron Sheik.
Ah, but Sheik's got a bow on his side.
This is true. And if he's got Bo on his side, he may also have Christian and Xavier Woods.
What's that team called again?
Something Bo-leaf.
Lack of belief.
That's it.
Suspension of disbelief.
I think that might be too much.
Well, no, see, because like Christian and Bo, like Bo Leave works for the Ken.
Oh yeah. And then there's Xavier Woods, who, I guess, I mean, you know, he does Bo Leaf in things like unicorns. Also, Randy Orton has the most fucked up win-loss record. He has 6 wins and 7 losses.
Jesus Christ. How many shows have we done?
I combined the... he absorbed the soul of Vintage Orton.
So is he fighting... at the end of this series of this universe... when this season wraps, is it gonna come down to him versus Heap Slater for the Dragon Balls?
Yes.
Tune in next time on Dragon Ball Z.
But that is it for NXT. Let's see if there's any news before we.
Sasha Banks is apparently unhappy with Vince McMahon.
What for?
She's not been fairly. Treat.
I can understand that.
I saw that on Twitter earlier.
So yes, all the news are to do with all the rivals, so we already know all this. But yes, what a show that might have been if I actually watched it.
I agree.
But yes, that is it for this week of NXT. Martin, it's your show. Do you want to sign off in your own special way?
Aye. Fuck you, page me.
No. Good night, everybody.
Bye-bye, everybody.